Good afternoon, everyone. How are we all doing today? We welcome you. Thank you so much. We welcome you to our concert. My name is Joe Carello, and this group of young musicians that you're going to hear is the Colgate Jazz Ensemble. On alto saxophone, that's Mark Moreira at the end there, please. Emily Corson, next to him, also on alto saxophone. This is Sam Kaplan on the tenor saxophone. Ben Yadowitz on the trombone, and Tarek Jerilu on the trumpet and piano. You can give them a nice big round of applause. How are you doing?
Welcome. Didn't look up until just now. Hello. Hello to the upper deck. We have all semester long been working with what we call backing tracks because we didn't have a drummer, bass player, and we have Tarek playing piano and trumpet, so we lost him on piano whenever he played the trumpet. So we used backing tracks that were amplified all through the semester and had a great time, but for this concert, we wanted to have some dear friends come and join us, and so we have my great friends on piano. This is Rick Montabano, who's the jazz piano instructor here at Colby. Rick Montabano on piano. You guys all know Mark Scheider, who played drums, and I've worked with Mark for many, many years, and he's the chaplain here at Colgate University. Good luck to you. So just a quick bit of explanation. During this semester, decided to take a little side trip and try to do some more combo-oriented jazz and pay tribute to some of the legendary musicians and composers of the music. So we're going to start our program with a blues, kind of a standard way to start off any jazz gig. And this was written by a great bassist named Oscar Pettiford, and it's called Blues in the Closet.
Thank you.
So this next composition that we'd like to play for you is kind of goes in the category of something that was played by many great jazz players. It was written by a guy named Bernie Miller, and it's simply called Bernie's Tune.
Thank you.
I do want to mention and thank Lorraine Joseph before I get too further into the program, because I'll get single-minded and forget. But you've been so helpful to me all semester long, and I truly appreciate it for everything you've done to help this happen. So thanks very much to Lorraine Joseph. We're going to continue with our tribute to some of the legendary musicians of this great music. Trumpeter Freddie Hubbard certainly made an immense contribution to the world of jazz. We're going to play one of his iconic compositions for you right now. This one is called Little Sunflower.
Thank you. Thank you.
So this next tune, this afternoon, we got together and rehearsed one time with the rhythm section, and we decided, hey, we're going to try this new thing. So there's a lot of flexibility in the way that we approached this concert for you to make it a little bit more spontaneous and more like a jazz combo gig that people would go and hear in the club. This next tune, it comes to us from a valve trombonist that played with Duke Ellington's band in the 1930s. Late 30s, early 40s. His name was Juan Tizol, and he wrote this tune, and Ellington had it in his book forever. It's called Perdido, and this is a new introduction that we worked out at rehearsal this afternoon. We hope you enjoy Perdido.
Thank you.
fun music, isn't it? You're not having fun?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I'm having fun, so it doesn't matter.
We've got a couple more for you, if that's okay. Can we play a couple more tunes for you? You got time for that? So right now, we're going to turn to the world of Sonny Rollins, one of the saxophone colossus. That was his nickname, Sonny Rollins, right? That was a recording he made, and he still is a colossus. I understand he's decided to put down the saxophone, but how old is Sonny Rollins? 90, 80, 90?
90, I would say.
90, yeah. So just decided that he wasn't going to concertize anymore, but fabulous, just a ferocious force in the world of jazz music. So this was a composition that he wrote, and everybody plays it, you know. It's the kind of thing that if you show up on a gig where people are calling tunes, jam, kind of jam session type of gig, somebody will call this tune. It's called St. Thomas. We hope you enjoy our version.
Thank you.
One of the people that I enjoyed listening to in my life, I love telling stories, so very, indulge me. There was a grocery store when I was growing up, and maybe Lorraine and I came from the same sort of neighborhood, and there was a place called Shop City. You remember Shop City? And in Shop City, there was an Acme Market. You guys remember the Acme chain of markets? And in the Acme Market, there were albums, really cheap ones, that the record company had. They called them cutouts. In the corner, there was a little like a hole punch. And they were 99 cents. And I saw this recording there one day. Cannonball Avenue plays Fiddler on the Roof. And I said, geez, I've heard of this guy. He's pretty good at it. I was a little kid. So I said, I bought that Cannonball Adderley record, Julian Cannonball Adderley, one of the greatest saxophone players. The first tune was To Life, and I'm telling you, if you go on YouTube and plug in Cannonball Adderley plays To Life from Fiddler, you're going to hear something that is very sweet. At any rate, it had me hooked. And years later, I bought the CD version, had some extra tunes on it, and one of them was this tune. I'm not sure this was on the original recording because it's not part of the music from Fiddler on the Roof. But it was written by a gentleman who played in Cannonball Sextet. His name is Charles Lloyd, and great tenor saxophonist. And it's just a tune that I really enjoy, and we're going to close with kind of exciting. It's up-tempo. Everybody, a lot of the band's going to solo on it. We hope you enjoy. We hope you've enjoyed our program. Have you had a good time here today? Yeah. And we're going to close off this Charles Lloyd composition that he did play with Cannonball Sextet. And this one's called Sweet Georgia Bright. And it is, it's kind of bright.
You're the last solo, okay? Well, of course, like Rick, you might play one at the end. So you need four of them.
Cool.
One, two, one.
Ha 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 ha